GOQii. Be the force.
I am your GOQii coach, Niyatii N Shah, and today's class is on sexuality matters. Today's topic is understanding the reproductive system of a male. It is important to know the basics of our own body, the physiology of our body, to then be able to understand the later complex parts and all the stuff that we want to know about sex and sexuality. When we say reproductive system, there are two things we're talking about. One is the outer body part we can see, and internal organs which we don't, and how they both function and what are the basics we need to know about it. Correct? So first I'll be talking about the external, and second I'll be talking about the internal system. Yes. I want to start with, are these two organs, I'm keeping it here so that I can also see what I am talking about. Great. So I was talking the root, the shaft, and the glans penis, okay, the head of the penis. Now, this constitutes the entire penis length. Now, the glans penis is the most sensitive part of the penis, and it has the most nerve endings, which is also called, as I said, the head of the penis. So now the next reproductive, the part is the scrotum. Okay, this is the scrotum. Scrotum is this bag of skin which hangs outside your body behind the penis. Okay, behind the penis you have this bag with two glands in it. One of the gland is shown here, which is called the testes. Okay, this is your scrotum, and there are two glands which are called the testes. Now there is this thick a hood kind of a organ that you can see. Okay, this is called epididymis. This is a highly coiled tube that lies at the back of the testes, over the testes like this, like a hood. And all the sperms from the testes must pass through this organ when they mature, and they start to swim into the other organs in the male reproductive system, the internal system. Okay, can you see this junction here near the prostate? Now this is, the bladder is also connected to the urethra. As we said, the urethra has two functions, pass the urine as well as the semen. So this is the junction where it happens. Now just like the food and the windpipe that you have in your throat, this is also a junction where there is a valve. So it decides whether the urine has to pass or the semen has to pass. Both cannot pass together. So if you really have a strong erection and you are stimulated, the valve will close the bladder pipe here, and you will not be able to urinate when you are sexually stimulated or very, very active and you have an erection. But a complete erection, I would say. Our class for the reproductive system, guys, and I am hoping that you got a lot out of it today, and it was very, very important to take this and understand your reproductive system. Okay, so thank you for being here, and I appreciate all of you right here, and that brings me to the end of our class today.